Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of MySQL Server on Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to install Workbench, and I'm going to show you how you can easily write simple queries, how to fetch data from your table, all of that on this video. So this video is going to be a bit long, but I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install MySQL, you need to first simply go to favorite browser, and then you need to search over here, MySQL download, and hit enter. So that's going to show you this www.mysql.com as a first search result. So you need to click on this MySQL downloads, and that going to redirect to the official site of MySQL. So here you need to scroll down and you'll get this MySQL community GPL downloads. So you need to open that, and that's going to show you all these different links. So from here you need to click on this MySQL installer for Windows. So when you click on that, it's going to show you this MySQL community downloads, and under that you'll be able to see the latest version of MySQL, that is version 8.2.38. So depending upon what time you are installing, you might see a different version. You know, over here you might see 8.0.39 or 8.0.40. You know, you might see different versions here. But whatever I'm showing on this video, the steps will be pretty much same. Alright, and if I see there is a major difference, I'm going to make another video. You don't need to worry about that. Just follow the video. So all you need to do is you need to just simply land over to this page. So this link also I'm going to provide right in our description. So all you need to do is you need to just simply land over to this page, and here you'll be able to see there are two MSI installer, right? So one of them is web community, another is installer community. So I always recommend you to install this one, alright? So that is 303.6 MB file. So just simply click on the download button, and that's going to redirect to this page. So here you need to click on no thanks, just start my download, and you can see that our file is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded this file, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser, I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see the file is already been downloaded over here. So just simply double click on it to start installing our MySQL. And here it might also ask you about the app that you are trying to install. Isn't a Microsoft verified app? So don't worry, it's a totally trustworthy app. So just simply click on install anyway. And there you go. MySQL installer is slightly open. So let's first minimize our download directory. And it will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And it's going to again ask you for administrative privileges. So again, you need to click on yes. And there you go. So two times it's going to ask you for administrative privileges, and you need to click on yes. And then you'll be able to see this screen. So here you need to click on custom, and then you need to click on next. So you'll be able to see all these different products. So you need to expand your MySQL server, and you need to select this one, and then you need to click on this arrow. So that's going to list you this MySQL server under product to be installed. Similarly, you need to also expand your applications. Then you need to also expand your MySQL workbench, and then you need to select this one, and then you need to click on this arrow. Similarly, if you want to use shell or router, you can always, you know, expand this and you can select. So I am going to also select shell. So click on this arrow, and there you go. All these three products are going to be installed. So just simply click on next. Ready to be installed, click on execute, and there you go. You can see it is rightly started. So let's wait for some time. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that all of our products, MySQL server, workbench, MySQL shell, everything is properly installed. So you can just simply click on next over here. So now it's time to configure. So see, it is ready to be configured. Just simply click on next, and there you go. So here you need to keep everything as a default. So remember this port number, then we are going to use TCP/IP protocol, and also we have to check this open Windows firewall ports for network access. So now you need to keep everything as a default, and then you need to click on next. So now it is telling to use a strong password, totally fine, click on next. And here, if you want to create a new user, you can always click on this add user, and you can create a new user. I'm going to use the root user, which is root. and I'm going to repeat the same password root, and I'm going to click on next. So our Windows service name will be MySQL Server 80, and all other things you need to keep it default and click on next. And here also you need to keep this default and click on next. Click on execute, and it's going to start executing all the configuration steps now. So again, it will take some time. I'm going to again come back once it is done. So we'll come back once again. So now you can clearly see that all our configurations are directly done. So you can just simply click on finish. So click on next over here and click on finish. So that's going to start launching our MySQL Workbench. And you can see that our MySQL Workbench is rightly opened. So let's first maximize it. And here you can see our root user. So if you click on that, it's going to ask you for password. So let's give that password root and save password in vault. Click on OK. And you can see that our MySQL is properly open. So here is our query window. So here you can write simple queries. Let's first create our database. So create database employee, just simply select and run that. So our database is rightly created. Let's create one table. So let's create a table HR with a couple of columns as ID and name. So just, you know, simply select this and click on this icon, and it's going to start creating your table. So you can see that it is throwing one error. So that is because we haven't selected our table, our database. So we need to give that employee.hr, the table name. And if you run this again, you can see that it is properly executed. So our table is properly created. So you need to give your database name dot your table name. All right. So after that, let's insert a couple of values. So I have written simple insert statement. So insert into HR your table name, then ID name, the couple of column that you are having, ID and name, and then values. So here you need to provide your value field. So I'm giving ID as 1, Rohit Sharma, and similarly I'm going to insert another value, that is 2, ID 2, Virat Kohli. So now I'm just going to select this and insert one by one. So again, you can see I have made that mistake. So you need to provide your database name. So insert into employee.hr. So just simply select this, click on insert. So one row affected, properly done. Again, select this, click on this icon. You can see one row affected. Now let's say you want to see all the values that you have inserted on your table. So if you do select start from your database name employee.hr, and if you just simply execute this statement, click on this icon, you can see all the values properly shown over here. Virat Kohli and Rohit Sharma are properly shown on our HR table. Right, so in this way you can easily install latest version of MySQL. You can also install MySQL Workbench. You can start working on your SQL queries. I have created Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I'm posting coding related videos. So if you're interested, please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. And I have also created a Geeky Script blogging channel. So if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And recently I'm posting a lot of videos on WordPress and WooCommerce. So recently I have posted this video of e-commerce. If you're interested, you can also watch all these different videos. I'm going to put all the links in your description. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.